Uterine fibroids are the most common abnormality of the uterus. Can these benign tumors cause a miscarriage? An excellent new study has given us some answers. Stay tuned. Each year, 1 million women in the USA have a miscarriage. About 1 in every 5 women have fibroids. Fibroids are benign growths that arise from the muscle cells of the uterus. Fibroids start as one cell, but can grow larger, sometimes much larger. Some fibroids grow inside of the uterine cavity, some grow in the muscle wall of the uterus, and some grow on the outside of the uterus. It is possible to have one fibroid or multiple fibroids, and in one location or in multiple locations. Recently, I released an episode of Infertility TV in which I reviewed the results of a study which found that any alcohol used by a person during pregnancy will increase the risk for miscarriage. That study was part of a larger research project called Right From the Start, or RFTS. Today, I will discuss the results of another study from RFTS. In this study, over 5,000 pregnant people in the USA were recruited either before they became pregnant or early in the first trimester. Each of these people had an ultrasound to look for fibroids. 11% of the people were found to have one or more uterine fibroids. The study compared how often miscarriages occurred in the group that had fibroids compared to the group that didn't. They found that the risk for miscarriage was the same in both groups. Overall, about 11% of the pregnancies miscarried in each group. Next, the researchers compared people that had no fibroids to those with one fibroid, and then those with two or more fibroids. Again, they did not find any increase in the miscarriage risk based on the number of fibroids. In order to look at the effect of the size of the fibroids, they did two different calculations. They looked at the total volume of space that the fibroids took up in the uterus and split them into 4 groups. They also divided the patients into 4 groups based on the size of the single largest fibroid. In both instances, there was no difference in the miscarriage risk based on the size of the individual or total sizes of the fibroids in the uterus. Finally, they looked at the location of the fibroids in the uterus and divided them into 3 groups: fibroids on the outside of the uterus, fibroids in the muscle wall of the uterus, and those that appeared to be nearer to the uterine cavity. Again, no difference was found. I will add my own opinion here. Using only an ultrasound, as they did in this study, it is sometimes difficult to see fibroids that are inside the uterine cavity or those that may be causing distortion of the uterine cavity, especially during pregnancy. These types of fibroids, however, may be the type that are most likely to cause a miscarriage. A better way to look at these types of fibroids is to do an ultrasound in which the doctor first squirts fluid into the uterine cavity. This is called a saline ultrasound, or hysterosonogram. Another method is to look inside the cavity directly using a hysteroscope. I don't think this study can draw any firm conclusions about these types of fibroids. My Infertility TV recommendation is that fibroids that are in the muscle wall of the uterus or on the outside do not need to be removed. These fibroids do not seem to increase the risk for miscarriage, and removing them will not reduce the risk for having a miscarriage. It is still reasonable, however, to remove fibroids that occupy the uterine cavity or causes the shape of the uterus to be distorted. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.